Now, if you're anything like me, you might be tired of your iPhone not living up to its full potential. Now, what if I told you that you could supercharge your iPhone experience with just a few simple tweaks? Well, welcome to iPhone Insider, the very first video where I'm teaching you the ultimate guide to hidden iPhone tricks. Today, we're diving deep into 12 game-changing features that will help you revolutionize how you use your iPhone, from boosting your network speed to fortifying your privacy and ensuring that you never miss a call from those people that matter most. This is your ultimate guide to how to use your iPhone and make it work for you. Trust me, you don't want to miss out on any of this. And if you're excited to unlock your iPhone to its full potential, hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell, because you don't want to miss what's coming next. First, let's talk about messages. You know, those are those things that contain everything from essential work details to the cherished memories that you have with your friends and family. Now, how many of you just upgraded to a brand new iPhone this year and realized that some of your messages did not make the jump? Now, let me tell you how to fix that. You're gonna go into settings, go to iCloud, go over to iCloud in the second panel, click show all, and then click on messages. Now you wanna turn on sync this iPhone, but don't stop there. Click on manage storage, click on top conversations, and here's gonna be a list of conversations that you have in your iPhone that are taking up the most amount of room on your device. Now you might have a 128 gig iPhone, you might have a 64 gig iPhone. Heck, you might be rocking a 32 gig iPhone if you are. I'd love to know what kind of iPhone that you have. But here you can delete all the messages that really you might not need anymore that are taking up space both on your device and in iCloud. Next up, let's talk about privacy. Now in today's world, data is almost as valuable as gold, and I think that you should be protecting your data like it is Fort Knox. Now, Private Relay is a paid service as part of iCloud Plus, but I like to think of it as a personal bodyguard for your data. It hides all your IP addresses while you're surfing the web and encrypts your browser data. It is 99 cents per month, which you go ahead and pay for. You also get a few additional features, but if you do have iCloud Plus, I would suggest go ahead enabling it and browsing with a little bit more peace of mind and a little bit more sense of security. Now, last but not least, let's do some digital spring cleaning. Let's go back to our device. We're gonna go ahead and hit settings. We're gonna click on our name at the very top here, and we're gonna go down to where it says iCloud again. Now here we're gonna click on iCloud Backup, which is the third panel down, and it's gonna show us a list of all our devices that have been backing up to iCloud. Now if you have any devices that are in that list that you no longer use, you no longer have, maybe you got rid of the device, you wanna delete it there because it's just taking up space that you can use as part of your storage plan. You can kind of liken this to cleaning out your attic. You really don't wanna do it, but at the end of the day, once it's done, you do feel better about yourself. At least I do. Now that we got iCloud settings out of the way, let's talk about something that is on everyone's mind, that is speed and connectivity. You know that feeling when you're using your phone, you're on 5G, but you just don't know why it is taking so long to open up the web page or to browse the internet. Now, I've got something for you. This is a setting that we'll change. Let's head over to settings. We'll go to cellular. Let's click on cellular data options, and we're gonna click on voice and data. Here, we're gonna change it from auto to on. This will make your phone always prefer a 5G signal, even if there's a strong 4G signal available. So you might see an impact to battery, but I mean, really, that's the price that you have to pay for speed. If you're like me and you live in an area with strong 5G coverage, you wanna make the most of it. So here, go to data mode and change it from standard to always allow more data on 5G. I'm gonna go into settings, I'm gonna go to cellular, I'm gonna change my data mode from standard to allow more data on 5G. And this is gonna ensure that I'm not just connected to 5G, but again, I'm squeezing every little bit of performance and speed out of my device that I'm paying for. Let's move on to setting number 6. This is call on other devices. Now, I love my Apple ecosystem. I have my iPad, my iPhone, my computer. They all work wonderfully together. But what I don't like is when someone calls me and then all of a sudden there is an orchestra, a cacophony of devices ringing together. So I make sure that I turn off calls on other devices, except for my iPad mini, because I love taking phone calls on my iPad mini. I mean, who doesn't want to feel like they're kind of like Dick Tracy taking a phone call on a little mini tablet? Okay, we've talked about iCloud and cellular settings. But what about those constant interruptions and dings that you get throughout the day? Notifications. Because notifications can be a real productivity killer. That's why I like to have scheduled summary turned on. I set mine to 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. and to 6 p.m. when I'm really gonna have time to check my device. I'm not busy working or doing something else. So I set up a third one, which is the 12 p.m. one. And it's really been a game changer because I now have more time to really kind of parse or triage all of the alerts that are coming in between those times. And it's just not as overwhelming. Now let's talk about number 8, announce notifications. I don't know about you, but announce notifications to me is the worst feature that Apple has ever announced. It does not work consistently and really developers are not taking advantage of it. I don't want to get notifications. I turn that off right away because I value my peace and quiet time and I think you should too. Now, staying on that same thread, let's talk about reducing disturbances. Have you ever jumped out of your skin when you received an unexpected, you know, emergency alert, Amber alert, like many of us did yesterday in the United States. Well, let's turn that off because it is annoying as all can be. Go to settings, notifications, scroll down to government alerts, bam, flip that, turn it off. You will not get notifications from any more emergency alerts. Now let's talk about something that's overlooked and will really make a big difference on your iPhone experience. It's gonna be Siri and search. Did you know that you can choose Siri's voice when she's speaking to you? Now it's a minor tweak, but I like to change my interactions with Siri to make it more enjoyable because it's my phone. I wanna use it the way I want to. You go to settings, go to Siri and search, go to tap on Siri voice. And from there you can pick up the voice that you want to have that's gonna be most pleasant for you. Now I use Siri Voice American number 3 because I just like the way that it sounds and it's a little bit more lifelike. Which one are you using? Let me know down in the comments below. Setting number 11, ending a call with Siri. Now many people might not know about this feature because it is brand new in iOS 17, but now you have the ability to use your voice and tell Siri to end the phone call that you're on, or FaceTime call actually as well. And it does work in voice apps. So imagine that you're walking in from the grocery store or you are in the car, you're feeding your kid. There's many different scenarios where your hands are full and you just don't have the ability to end the phone call. Well, here you do, you turn that feature on and you can just tell your personal assistant to end the phone call. Easy peasy, the call is ended. Now, Control Center is a resource that many people don't use to its fullest capability, and you can get to maximize Control Center with these simple tweaks. Tweaks. First, I like turning off home controls in Control Center because it's just too cluttered, and I really don't need to see my home controls there because they are available in the home app, or you can even create a shortcut widget on your one of your app screens. Now, if you find it overwhelming, you can disable home controls by going into settings, going to Control Center, and remove home controls, but we're not stopping there. I like to customize Control Center to make it more easy for me to find what I'm looking for. For example, I removed the shortcut for flashlight in Control Center because one, it's on the home screen, two, I could use my voice, and three, I actually have a hardware shortcut that I use more often, which I'm gonna share with you in the next video, so make sure you are subscribed for that. But here I've actually done a few other things. I've added the code scanner, I've added screen recording, I've added the text size adjustment, which is the sleeper app, especially if you are middle-aged, your eyes are getting bad, you wanna adjust the text in-app or across all apps. This is awesome. Guided access, if you wanna hand your phone to someone, maybe your kid to play a game or something like that, and even the magnifier app. Now for me, I think about things in alphabetical order, so I sort them alphabetically, so that way it's very easy for me to find them, but you could sort them any way you want, you do you, you let me know what you think. Now, we've covered a ton of different settings for you to change, everything from optimizing iCloud to your cellular connectivity, and really making sure that you are supercharging your iPhone, but the action does not stop there. I have got more, it is gonna be in the next video. I wanna make sure that you check it out. We're gonna dive into everything, including life-changing features called emergency bypass. It's like the red phone. Anytime that this person calls you, there's always gonna ring your phone no matter what state it is in. You don't wanna miss out. Now guys, if you found this guide helpful, hit the like button, let YouTube know that this video is helpful. And if you wanna make sure that you don't miss out, hit subscribe, ring that notification bell. My name is Mike. Do you have a tip that I didn't talk about? Let me know down in the comments below. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next video.